Welcome to this YouTube channel. In this video we are going to talk about top 10 test batsmen of all time. So before starting this video, like this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel for future updates. Cricket, sometimes known as the batsman's game, has intrigued and astonished its fans for years with a variety of exquisite strokes and footwork. With only a willow to work with, the game's finest batters created a reputation for themselves by consistently whacking the most fearsome bowlers or standing firm against the cherry-wielding guys. These batsmen have made it to the list of the top 10 greatest batsmen across all generations thanks to their incredible averages and ability to rake in regular performances by having a single-handed impact on a team's outcomes. The omission of West Indian George Headley, commonly known as the Black Bradman, and South African Graham Pollock, both of whom carried the responsibility of their respective teams, averaging well over 60 in the test matches they competed in, is due to the criteria of a minimum of 50 test matches. Number 10. Greg Chappell, Australia. Tests 87, runs 7,110, average 53.86, 124, highest score 247. Despite missing 2 years of international cricket after joining the breakaway World Series cricket, Greg Chappell, with awe-inspiring records, makes it to a ranking of the top 10 batsmen of all time, pipping Ricky Ponting. Chappell remained a combative competitor against bowlers like Michael Holding, Colin Croft, and Joel Garner, paving the way for an aggressive generation of Australian players who would go on to dominate international cricket. Number 9. Sunil Gavaskar, India. Tests 125, runs 10,122, average 51.12. 134, highest score 236. Gavaskar paved the way to prominence long before Tendulkar captivated the Indian sphere's imagination, encouraging a nation to rub hands with the game's legends. Gavaskar's style of play relied on near-flawless technique and unequaled concentration levels. He was the first player to score 10,000 test runs. To be the best, they say, you have to hold yourself to high standards when competing against the best in the profession. This is an area where Gavaskar excelled. The great West Indies of the 1970s and 1980s, often known as the best team to have ever played Test cricket, scored 2,749 runs at an average of 65 with 13 centuries. Number 8. Sir Vivian Richards, West Indies. Tests 121, runs 8,540, average 50.23, 124, highest score 291. Long before the likes of Sehwag and Gilchrist entered the game, Viv Richards made a name for himself as the most fearsome and dominating batsman the bowlers had ever faced, thanks to his inane tendency to defy the bowling assault all over the park. The batsman from the Caribbean is still regarded as the most feared cricketer of all generations, with pitch-perfect timing and an attitude that oozed gallons of confidence. Number 7. Jacques Kallis, South Africa. Tests 150, runs 12,260. Average 57.02, 141, highest score 224. If international cricket were a museum, and all the cricketers were precious artworks, Jacques Kallis would be the Mona Lisa of this museum, priceless and one in a billion. This remark perfectly captures the atmosphere of Jacques Kallis, the world's most consistent, near-perfect all-rounder. Kallis was awarded the most man of the match accolades in the history of Test cricket for his unwavering perseverance in the face of adversity. He remained a visual treat, the classic and traditional unsung hero whose achievements were frequently overshadowed by Ponting's ferocity or Tendulkar's divinity. Number 6. Sir Garfield Sobers, West Indies. Tests 93, runs 8,032, average 57.78, 126, highest score 365. Sir Garfield Sobers remains the finest all-rounder to have ever played the game, combining an enviable batting technique with an identifiable boisterous Caribbean flair. The left-hander was the first batsman in history to slam six sixes in an over against Malcolm Nash, and he was just as good on the offside as he was while bringing up his 235 wickets. Sobers stood out from the West Indian team of heroes who would go on to conquer the cricketing arena in the coming decade, holding the world record for the greatest individual score in tests after scoring 365 in just his 14th outing. Number 5. Brian Lara, West Indies. Tests 131, runs 11,953, average 52.28, 134, highest score 400. Brian Lara was tasked with the difficult task of revitalizing West Indian cricket after it appeared to be on the verge of collapse, as well as reproducing the brilliance of players like Sobers, Richards, and George Headley. Following in the footsteps of his more experienced peers, Lara not only kept up with them in terms of steady performance, but he also carved out a space for himself away from their shadows. The Trinidadian, who finished his career with two first-class scores of over 400, gave the audience a glimpse of the force that West Indies cricket once possessed. Number 4. Sir Walter Hammond, England. Tests 85, runs 7,249, average 58.45, 122, highest score 336. Sir Walter Hammond's excellence can be summarized by the fact that he was frequently compared to Don as the finest batsman of the pre-war era. Hammond and Bradman had a tense competition during their careers, especially after the Australian shattered his world record by scoring 336 runs, the highest individual test score. With 22 centuries, Hammond was widely regarded as England's best batsman. At the time of his retirement, he held the world record for most test runs, which was only recently surpassed by Alistair Cook. Number 3. Sir Jacques Hobbs, England. Tests 61. Runs 5,410, average 56.94, 115, highest score 211. Hobbs, the original master of cricket, was a forerunner in the sport, introducing a number of new shots to his arsenal. Hobbs was the first batsman to average over 50 in Test cricket and the first cricketer to be knighted by the Queen, despite having received no professional coaching. Sir Hobbs remains a major impact on modern-day batsmen, having scored 199 centuries in competitive cricket and 7 test centuries after the age of 40, including a century at the age of 46. Number 2. Sachin Tendulkar, India. Tests 188, runs 15,470, average 55.44, 151, highest score 248. He was India's savior, the person to turn to when the country was in trouble. Tendulkar's grandeur lay beyond the record books and his logic-defying constancy after shouldering the responsibility of the entire Indian populace for 2.5 decades. Tendulkar, who had faced Wasim and Wakar as a bashful 16-year-old in Faisalabad, began stamping his authority in every country, against every bowler, and became his nation's identity and pride as the years and decades passed. Tendulkar resisted Akhtar's pace and Warne's brilliance with aplomb, establishing himself as one of the best cricketers the world has ever seen. Is there anything better than the Don apostrophe question mark on that one? The jury is still out. Number 1. Sir Don Bradman, Australia. Tests 52, runs 6,996, average 99.94, 129, highest score 334. Don the Great. Bradman's aura made him a benchmark in the world of cricket, with every other renowned batsman being judged against this flamboyant Australian. He finished with an average that has become the most well-known sporting record. Bradman achieved the pinnacles in the world of sports with his superhuman stats by transcending the game he played, branding himself as the apex of human success. What do you think about this video? Do let us know down in the comments section below. If you enjoyed this video and want to hear from us again, be sure to hit that subscribe button before you go.